Hey everybody, Ultimate Oddball here. Today I'm going to talk about interoception. Interoception is the name for the sensory system which involves various input from within the body. This includes feelings of hunger, thirst, fullness, the feeling of needing to have a bowel or bladder movement, and any other sensory input which comes from within, even the movement of organs in one's heartbeat. Autistic people often have sensory input differences, and interoception may be part of those differences. For some, this presents in conjunction with other sensory input differences as aversion due to pain, discomfort, a likelihood to induce anxiety and/or panic, even trauma. For others, interoception issues display as a seeking out of these sensory inputs because of how doing so makes them feel. Some behavior which is often confusing to non-autistic people may be explained by interoceptive issues which drive a desire to experience said sensory input. There's also the potential for interoception to be experienced as a difficulty in sensing these various input. This is what I personally experience. I don't feel hungry until I've gone many hours without eating. I don't feel thirsty until my mouth is bone dry. I don't feel I need to go to the bathroom until I really need to go. I eventually noticed these things in time, but it's likely that others do not. I also struggle to differentiate between areas of pain in my body or types of pain. It's important to examine and understand how various sensory input differences affect autistic people so that they and or those around them can adapt to those differences and find ways to address them which aren't destructive or dangerous or unhealthy. For example, since I know I won't become aware of being thirsty or hungry, I can simply force myself to eat and drink on a regular schedule. Obviously, that's a pretty easy fix, and some will be more difficult, but efforts should be made to find an adjustment if possible. Being aware of interoceptive issues means you can be aware of the problems which may arise as a result of those sensory differences. For those under-responsive, this means taking steps to address needs based on a formulaic system rather than relying on sensory input which may or may not come. For those over-responsive, this may mean finding a way to lessen the severity of the negative feelings which come with that input through various methods. It's also very important that people who don't have interoceptive issues do their best to be understanding of these differences, even when the expression of said differences are difficult to deal with. Well, thanks for coming by. Have a good day. Hey everybody, Ultimate Oddball here. If you want to stay up to date with my videos, click subscribe. I release a new video on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. I do gaming commentary and review. I talk about my experiences on the autism spectrum, and I share my opinions and thoughts on a variety of matters. My hope is that, through my videos, I can help to dispel some of the misinformation, confusion, and negativity people have regarding autism. Thank you for helping me do that by watching these videos.